Guys, I am back in El Salvador. I bought a last minute ticket. I put my life on hold. Now, why did I do that? Because it's so fun here and the people are incredibly friendly. That's part of it. But there are three main reasons why I came back to El Salvador, and you want to know them. The first reason why I came back to El Salvador was because of you watching this now. The amount of love and feedback that I got from my previous vlog from all of you made me make the decision that I need to come here and show you more of El Salvador and give you a deeper look inside this amazing country.
This is Oculta.
This is
Oculta, bro.
This is where we were supposed to go last time. Gracias.
The first one, it is Salvador. Welcome to the second time.
And the second reason that I came back to El Salvador is a very important reason. There is a presidential election that is a huge, huge deal in this country because Bukele, the current president, is not allowed to run again, but he's deciding that he's going to change the constitution so he can run again.
Anuncio al pueblo salvadoreño que he decidido correr como candidato a la presidencia.
In a few days, if Bukele loses the election, all the gangsters might be released from the prisons. So it's a very serious election, which is one of the main reasons why I'm here.
De seguro, más de algún país desarrollado, pero no son ellos los que decidirán, sino el pueblo salvadoreño.
I'm in a pretty sketchy area.
What would happen now if Bukele wasn't president in this area?
This area, no way you can stop the car. No way. This is the dangerous city in San Salvador. Now everything looks clean. You can walk, you can do so many things right now. So nice. I don't know why people hate Bukele. I don't understand that.
We're on our way to Sonsonate, hitting different places on the way. We're in Santa Tecla right now.
Hey, YouTube.
Yes, YouTube.
No, my friend.
No, YouTube? Okay. No,
where are you from?
Canada.
Canadian?
Yes.
Hey, my friend, welcome to El Salvador.
Thank you.
This country is the best. In this moment, people are talking about this country, but not everything is true. It's not dangerous, but you can take care. And this subject, El Salvador is example in Latin America.
Okay, yeah.
And this subject, but an economy, not much. I have a question. My language is very bad.
No, it's good.
You too?
Yes, you too.
He is a great person.
Thank you. So that was a nice random guy. I think he was homeless. He smelled like he was homeless. Anyway, now it's time to get to Sonsonate and tell you guys the third reason why I came here. Let's go. Loco. So we're going to a fair right now and we're gonna take all the kids there, but this was Fernando's school, and right here Fernando grew up, and he said if you were to walk down this street when he lived here, automatic guarantee you're getting like, that is insane,
bro. Right now I don't feel to go over there.
You don't even want to walk over there?
No way.
Wow.
No way. Because before it was the train, the one we used for cargo train. That was a tourist place.
You don't even want to walk there right now?
Not right now.
Wow. this is the fair in Sonsonate. This is set up for the kids. As you can see, it's all kids' rides. This area that the fair is built on was a prison. Before Bukele, this was the prison of Sonsonate. As you can see here, the prison walls are still standing. Once Bukele came into power and he built that mega prison, this one was condemned. They still kept the facade of the prison up. It seems so weird to put a kids' fair on a prison ground where thousands of people died. So how are all these people going to fit in the car? They get in the back.
Ahí cabe.
Okay, wow.
Caballito. Así nos metemos. Pura sardina.
So the third reason why I am in El Salvador is because we came to this festival that only happens once a year. What's the name of the festival, bro?
Virgen de Candelaria.
And it's crazy. It's a 7-day party every single night. Let's go. Busier. Wow, this festival is insane.
No me respeta mis dos dólares.
Papi, se la pongo aquí.
Ay,
seguro que la vas a botar.
Sí.
So it's 4 in the morning right now.
Yeah.
And we're in a restaurant.
In a restaurant.
Open.
Open.
They're paying the staff here. I don't know how anyone makes money, but it's crazy. Nobody else is in here, but okay.
How do you people make money?
How do you make money? I don't understand. Look, they got cakes, they got hot dogs, they got burgers, they got... They have everything here.
This is the beans. I don't know what is that.
Fernando, what are you getting, bro? I want what you're getting.
Okay, beans.
Yeah.
Tamales.
Tamales.
Plátanos.
Beans with rice.
Oh, dos. I want those too.
What's inside a tamale?
The tamale is nothing. It's nothing.
Nothing inside.
Trust the tamales, pero...
Okay, tamale. Let's go.
Ay, si hablas español, ¿pa qué me...?
Por favor.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
The capital.
This is for you.
Whoa. La Mexicana fuerte.
She can do it.
So we're at a Mr. Donut right now. I guess this place kind of sells everything. If you're from Vancouver, it's kind of like a Duffin's. There's nobody else here but us. And we keep wondering, how do people make money here? It doesn't really make sense. Staff are being paid for. The food is being paid for. The electricity is being paid for. Doesn't make sense to me. But viva Bukele, viva El Salvador.
Yes. Like a portion de queso, tamal de lote frito, agua de botella, hot dog.
Bro, that's fucking delicious.
You recording?
Yeah.
Okay.
Este es otro mundo. Este es otro mundo, marica. Mi hermanita. I want to say something to you. Before my sister is here, which is the best breakfast you eat en El Salvador?
Yo sé, Susan.
¿Cuándo fue la mejor comida que comí en El Salvador? El desayuno mejor, dice. En tu hermano.
Ya.
En tu hermano, el mejor.
Pica.
Trust me.
It's very hot.
He already tried this. You already tried.
It is very hot. Matthew would like this. He likes hot.
Matthew
likes
this.
You see?
I'm gonna tell people when they see Mr. Donut, they should come. There's no Mr. Donut.
It is a Mr. fucking Donut.
It is a Mr. Donut.
It is, dude.
I never seen this in my life.
Okay, I take a picture and send it to you. This is America.
What's up everybody, day two in El Salvador. I am in Sonsonate, as you know. This is the hotel I'm staying in. It's actually quite nice. It's only $60 a night. It has a pool, restaurant, comfortable room. I like it. So I don't know why, but the restaurant was closed today. So I found this spot right here. It's down the road, maybe a 5-minute walk. So we're gonna go check that spot out and we'll probably end up back at the festival tonight. Oh, it is hot. So let's go. All right guys, I made it to the restaurant here. It was a 5-minute walk, but it feels like I've been doing an hour cardio. The amount of sweat, maybe you can tell from the video how hot it is. This is unusual for someone like me to be standing here on the road holding a camera, so a lot of people are looking at me, but it's always love here in El Salvador. Always love, everyone's super friendly. I can't imagine what it used to be like before. Gracias. Wow. Guys, that was one of the best quesadillas I've ever had. If there are Mexicans watching this, I'm sorry. I'm sure you've had better quesadillas. You gotta show me. Invite me to your country. I wanna see it. And it was only $11. So now I'm going to Fernando's sister's house. You saw it before in my last vlog. If you didn't see my last vlog, check it out here. We're gonna relax for a bit, probably check out the seaside, and then festival again tonight. So let's go. So So it's about a 10-minute walk to Fernando's sister's house, down all these side streets as you see. I feel like if this was Mexico, I'd feel super, super unsafe. But something about the energy in El Salvador, right now at least, friendly, welcoming, good energy, positive vibes. I love it. I don't know why, but there are no sidewalks. It's hot. Did I say that already? It is hot. So as you saw, that bus just fly through the intersection. I just looked at the intersection, there's no stop signs there. So I mean, if a kid is coming out on his bike or another car is coming through, that bus is gonna destroy anything in its path. Bro, I followed the directions and I think I'm near, but... Okay. I followed the directions, but everything really looks the same here.
Buddy, you made it.
There's the capo.
You can make it to this house, you can go anywhere.
Good to see you, brother.
All
right.
Go see the familia.
Familia. Hello.
Hello.
Where are we going, bro?
Los Cobanos.
Los Cobanos.
Los Cobanos.
Right on the water.
You can swim in. You can do so many business over there. You can eat any kind of seafood.
Ah, okay. Let's go. Much more calmer than La Libertad. As Fernando said, it's for the poor people here. Supposedly the water's not this crazy. It's supposed to calm down in about an hour, so. But there are already people in the water. It's pretty cool here. More relaxed, tranquilo.
Soy uno de los seres que más ha soportado los fracasos. Siempre me dejaron las mujeres.
Pero por eso
he pasado al lado de una dama.
Going back to the festival tonight, but we can't be drinking those sugar drinks anymore, so we gotta buy the good stuff.
Salvador, tu donante sigue siendo el mejor. ¡Woo!
Podría decir porque la seguridad ha aumentado. Gracias a Dios ahora puedes andar tranquilo sin que te pase algo. Tenemos una diversidad de gastronomía de todo tipo. Hay comida salvadoreña, comida mexicana. Aparte de eso, el país de El Salvador es pequeño. Te queda cerca la montaña, la playa, conocer lugares turísticos. En cuestión de 2-3 horas te podés desplazar casi a cualquier departamento de El Salvador. Y la verdad es que estamos disfrutando de una seguridad que antes no se disfrutaba. Eso te puedo decir, que por eso invitamos a la gente que venga a El Salvador. Somos gente muy honrada, muy trabajadora, y que tratamos de recibir bien a toda la gente que viene de afuera.
Reyes de la Virgen en Facebook y en Instagram. Síganos y búsquenos para que vengan acá y prueben los tacos de Biblia. Estamos de Sonsonate, El Salvador.
Gracias. Te va bien, mi rey. Espero que disfruten la comida y que puedan visitarnos en nuestro local también. Dios te bendiga.
Gracias.
Gracias por todo.
3 a.m. right now. The stage is done, music is done, but people are still everywhere partying. The city is crazy. When it comes to festivals, it doesn't stop. More music just started. There's like mini parties everywhere.
Yeah.
But it's no cinema anymore. I was here like 35 years ago watching a movie there. I want to tell you one thing about this street. The hospital, Sonsonate Hospital, is over there.
Yeah.
Most of the time, it was 10 years, but it was not too much. Because where's the hospital? You normally, when the hospital it is, you know, I have a security. When you in the Sonsonate Capital, it's safe. And the outside is not safe.
So you said this festival you could go to, but it was getting home was the issue.
Yeah, of course. This is the problem.
That's when you get stopped.
Of course. This is where you get it. Fucking people kill you and shit like that.
It's like roadblocks.
Yeah, correct.
Wow.
What's up, bro?
What's up, brother?
Another gorgeous day in this hermosa país. Last night was crazy. Got home about 4 a.m., slept for 3 hours, and at 7 a.m., my stomach was completely messed up from those tacos. So I was in the bathroom between 7 and 9 a.m. this morning. It was rough. It seems that the poorest countries like to have the most fun. It's a country where most people don't have that much money, but they know how to have a really good time, and they can party for 7 days straight. It's the last day of the festival. There's a parade tonight. It's gonna be wild. I'm gonna try not to drink, but with that guy over there, you can't not drink. I mean, take a look at this, guys. I can't even tell what the yuca is. Which one is the yuca? There's so many things, you know? This one? Yuca?
That was a yuca.
Okay, this is a yuca. No, that's not yuca. And this one?
I think this is a liver.
Liver. And this one? Yuca?
That one, no, this one is like a tortilla.
This is the yuca.
That was a yuca.
Okay, I found the yuca. I hope my stomach will stay chill during this.
Hola, hola.
I didn't mention it in my last vlog, and if you haven't seen my last vlog, check it out. But the hospitality of Fernando's family is incredible, and I just want to give a shout out to them right now because they're so nice and welcoming and kind. And just really, really sweet people. Fernando's sister's husband, Alberto, he's our driver. He'll stay out with us all night, not drinking, and he'll drive us anywhere we need to go. Just a super cool guy. I just want to give them a bit of love. Por favor. Gracias.
Un pedacito de budín.
Para que lo tome con cafecito. Yo lo acabo de hacer ahorita.
Yes, please. She's getting me a coffee and some bread. She's so nice. Mmm. So soft, like sponge, and it's warm, and it has bananas in it. Oh my gosh. Wow. It's like a warm, melt in your mouth sponge cake. Oh, even the coffee is incredible.
Fernando, El Salvador is a big coffee country. Where can I find like some really good beans?
Nahuizalco.
Okay. Yeah, we almost died there.
Holy shit, look. Holy shit.
No sugar, it's delicious. So don't ask for con leche. People don't put milk in their coffees here, so I shouldn't. I have one viewer on here that mentioned in the comments before not to put anything in the coffee, remember? They offered to give me cream, but maybe you're watching this right now, but you commented on my last video saying when I drink coffee in this country, I shouldn't put anything in it, so cheers to you. Last night at the festival, and we got 9 people in a 5-seater. That's how they do it in El Salvador. So for the last day of the festival, there's a parade that goes from one side of the city to the other side of the city, and it's going down this street. People are just lining up, choosing their spots, and waiting for the parade to come through. There's food stands, people everywhere. They've been camping out here for hours. This is a huge deal. I wonder if you can feel the energy through the video now.
Sonsonate con nuestras bellas reinas de las fiestas patronales.
They're all throwing candy, but they're not really tossing it. They're like throwing it. And if you're not careful, you could get hit. Peligroso. To the park. It is insane here right now. So the parade is gonna stop on the street behind us.
It comes from that way now.
Ah, so it goes around
all
and comes
way,
down?
Around, all the way.
It's and like then stops like right here?
Yeah, stop here.
By the time it makes it here, it's gonna be about 10 p.m., 11 p.m., and the whole place is just gonna be lit up. Fireworks, everything. And this goes on till 5 in the morning.
Meanwhile, in my city,
for the 4th straight year, Vancouver will ring in the new year without any fireworks.
Buenos dias. Another beautiful morning here in El Salvador. Last night, as you know, was the last night of the festival, the Candelaria, and it was wild. But as I mentioned before, the presidential election is coming up in 2 days, hence why I'm wearing my Bukele shirt. I've spoken to a lot of different people about their opinions, and a lot of people love Bukele, but there are quite a few who do not, which is very interesting because the amount of things he's done for this country. Number one, most importantly, it's so safe here.
El Salvador now imprisons people at a higher rate than anywhere else in the world.
But the controversies that surround Bukele are that he has changed some constitutional things to make him stay in power longer or enact certain measures so that he could lock up all the criminals without fair trial.
Les juro por Dios que no comen un arroz y no me importa lo que digan los organismos internacionales que vengan a proteger a nuestra gente.
Under the state of emergency, they need no warrant to search any house or make an arrest.
Also, he has introduced new taxes on the people to help pay for all these expenses. These are just some of the reasons why people don't like Bukele. So, to start off the morning, I found a really highly rated cafe in the center, close to where the festival was yesterday. So let's go have some real Salvadorian coffee. Hopefully it's better than the last one I had here in my last vlog. I saw them scooping the milk out of a huge bucket. Tasteless. Hola, señor. If any other party wins, other than Bukele's party, the gangsters are going to be released from prison. Safety is gone. Tourism is gone. People are dying again. It'll be a sad, sad day. But by the time this is released, the results will already be out. I pray that Bukele wins for the people here and that tourism can boom here and this country can grow. Google Maps is taking me down here. Looks kind of sketch. Let's see. So far, people are nice. All right, guys. Now I am in the center of downtown Sonsonate. Hola. Hola. People are nice. As usual. So those are fireworks, not gunshots. If Bukele wasn't in power, those would probably be gunshots. So this looks like the shopping street. A lot of clothes, a lot of shoes. Pupusas. Of course, pupusas. This guy wants to yell out at me. people are cool here. I feel like I just have to keep the camera rolling because so many people are yelling. I have another 8-minute walk to get to the cafe. I was gonna Uber, I'm glad I did not Uber. This is exciting, different, sketchy a little bit. You feel the energy here? Latinos just do it differently. Everybody wants to say hi. How do you feel now compared to how it was before?
Yeah, it's good. Well, at least we have life, no more games. That's good. To give to the children, we have to give them education,
yeah,
protection,
yeah,
help.
Yeah.
I was in the United States before. I was in Boston, and they give you English classes as long as you can talk or have a great conversation with someone like you.
Nice.
Where are you from?
Canada.
Oh, está bueno. Me gusta.
Gracias, gracias.
I saw another partner like a week ago. He was from Canada too. And he said, you speak English? Yeah. Why you speak English and don't you work in the call center? Because I like to stay here.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Mitchell.
Mitchell. I'm Mario, brother.
Mario, nice to meet you. So, viva Bukele or what?
Yeah, viva Bukele.
Right on.
Thank you for visiting the country.
You're welcome.
Thank you for visiting the country.
So this is where the festival was last night. I never seen it in the daytime like this. A lot different with all the businesses open. cafe. Looks like they have everything here from coffee and food, large menu. They have alcohol here too, of course, in case I want to do a shot with my coffee, but not yet. That cafe was really cool. Now, next thing we have to do is get a cerveza. Coffee and beer, that's what you do when you're traveling, right? Second last evening here, we're going to Santa Ana to stay right on the lake, which used to be a volcano. I think it's gonna be epic. Vámonos.
Let's go.
This isn't coffee, by the way. I love El Salvador. We have a military stop right now.
Is it for passport?
Yeah, the passport.
You know, I take the passport, she's passport, I take it. She doesn't know I take the passport. What? As soon as they give you a passport, they don't say nothing.
They realize we're not from here, it's all good,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
But that's the first time we had a military stop.
Yeah, I know.
That's what keeps us safe, you know? But we are in the mountain, so it seems like everything is closed really early, but we found a place that might be still open, so we're gonna drive up. If you can see it here, it's all the way up at the top of the mountain. We're gonna go see what's going on up there. As you can see, we're in our sweaters. It's actually cold up here. It's only 700 meters above sea level, but it's cold. Checked out that bar on top of the hill. It was pretty ghetto, pretty hood. We just had one drink and then a fight broke out. So we drove a bit north, 20 minutes to the city of Santa Ana, and we're gonna check out this cerveceria that has some loud music playing, open till 2 a.m. Let's go.
So the club just closed at 3 a.m. Everyone's leaving the club drunk, but there's an after party just on the side street. They got drinks, they got food, it smells so good, and this will probably be going till 5, 6 a.m. This is crazy.
Here. It's no police here.
No police here.
Yeah, everybody knows he's fucking very drinky here.
So Fernando said that these parties used to happen a lot when he was growing up, but as soon as the gangsters came in, there was none of these. But now that Bukele's in, they're back. Gas station parties. So we're gonna grab some Chase, we're gonna grab some ice. We got a bottle already. We're gonna go try out the food there. God bless my stomach. Even in this gas station, the music is still going. It doesn't stop in this country.
Yuka.
This is actually pretty good. Chimichurri and salsa, that is really good. So that was choripan, chori for chorizo and pan for bread. Delicious. Good morning, everybody. Just woke up in a city called La Congo, I believe. And this lake behind me is Lake Cotapeque. It was a last minute decision to come here. And Fernando and Lupita were down. They're always down. They're so chill. And it was only 1 hour north of Sonsonate. This lake behind me was a volcano at one time. And about 50 to 70,000 years ago, it erupted and it turned into a lake. I didn't know that happened with volcanoes. Did you know that? I didn't know that. And supposedly down at the bottom of the lake, there's still lava and it's super hot. Pretty interesting. So we had to drive literally through the bush to get here, through the mountain. And it feels very high up, although the elevation is only 700 meters. Above sea level, but it's definitely colder up here. Definitely a different feel in the air up here. It's more fresh, more crisp. Even though there were no lights and no service on the road on the way up here, the road was really, really good. And of course, like everything in El Salvador, Fernando was saying, there's no way you could go up this road at night because there would be roadblocks by the gangsters on this road too. And I was asking him, like, why would they set up in the middle of nowhere? He said, because they're going to rob the trucks that are delivering food and services to the restaurants. I'm like, how crazy is that? You know, you're just a food delivery driver and you're getting robbed for your goods. It was crazy here back then. I wish I had more time here, but I wanted to at least just check it out and show you guys a little bit of it. About this area here, there's not much to do at all. So don't come here if you think there's gonna be restaurants throughout the night. Although there are a lot of restaurants open in the day. Also, this accommodation here, I saw it on Instagram and it looks super beautiful. It is super beautiful, but they didn't mention that you're staying in a container. So this was like $200 Canadian a night. And I mean, the view is incredible, as you can see. That's what you're paying for, but you're living in a container. And Fernando's been joking with me the whole time, telling him I put him in a container on vacation in the cold. Sauce in the Gucci bag. Bro, what if it leaks?
It's okay, she has to buy new one.
Amigos aquí, decirles algo en especial, la vida es un recuerdo, lo que queda, lo que disfrutamos. Bienvenido a Canadá, bienvenido a los que visitan desde Canadá a El Salvador, pues les mando un fuerte beso para toda esa gente hermosa, esa gente que va a venir aquí a la Pampa Coatepeque. Les deseo un buen viaje y espero tenerlo acá con Rafael. Aquí busquen a Rafita y será un gusto atenderlo.
talk English so that we can get a better deal.
You get a better deal.
What's this form for, bro?
If you die, people know who are you.
Ready to roll? Never been on a jet ski before. This water is pretty cold here, but it's really hot outside. So let's see how this turns out. Man, this thing goes fast. So like I said before, this lake used to be a volcano. The guy said that it's very, very deep, and at the bottom, it's still hot lava. But I mean, look how people are living here. Look at this house, for example. Guys, it is nice here. It is beautiful and hot. Like last night we needed jackets, now it's like we need tank tops. I'm telling you, this place is incredible. Bring your wife, bring your husband, bring your partner, bring your kids. This place is beautiful.
You want a chocolate?
Yeah, please.
I take the original chocolate.
That one?
Yes.
I'll do this one, please.
Okay.
No es.
Choco bananos. That's different. It's kind of weird eating this because it looks like, yeah, anyway. Lupita, can you please tell me what that is?
Pepino locos.
Yeah, pepino locos.
It's cucumber. Crazy cucumber.
Yeah.
Crazy cucumber.
Crazy, yeah, yes. Because there's so many things, spicy, sweet, all the shit. This is why it's crazy.
Gotcha. Oh yeah. Salsa, sí.
Salsa. Broma.
¿Tú quieres?
No, y como está, tranquilo.
¿Quieres pupusa?
Yo siempre como el frijol
porque. Okay. Time to say goodbye to the fam. Okay.
Buen viaje.
Gracias por todo.
Hi, Michelle. Mucho gusto.
Mucho gusto.
Nos vemos la próxima.
Papi, cuídate. Morro, ahí estamos. Vamos, tío. Vamos a seguir chambriendo. Vamos a seguir hablando de aquella mierda. Vamos a hablar de aquella mierda.
¡Bicha! Bendiciones, pues. Vaya usted, que nos vino a ver
aquí. Hasta pronto. Hasta pronto. Bye, Luna.
Bye.
Ah, pues, te veo allí, mariquita, en la casa, pues.
Dale. Ah, tú dices antes. Espérate que
quiero el show. Look, a pilsner. Look at that, a pilsner, bro. This is the original from El Salvador.
No, hold on.
Salud again. Lots of salud.
Salud.
So we stopped by to see Fernando's nephew here before going to San Salvador tonight to spend our last night in the country. What do you want to show?
It's a mechanic shop. He makes all the stuff in cars and trucks and everything. You see what he's doing in the
And that's the first mechanic shop you worked at?
I worked at, yes.
Wow. Okay.
Look, these are the cool people. This is a mechanic shop.
And it's
Salvador.
Wow.
Este lo acabo de alargar.
He spent the whole frame.
Complete. Oh wow, he expanded it.
Yeah.
10 metros y lo acabo de levantar.
3 feet.
For the suspension or two?
Suspension,
or?
Yes.
Wow.
The rear suspension. This is what he make here.
That's not easy work. It's not easy.
No, bro. Look, this one was broken because nobody have it. He had to make it own. Nobody find it. He make my own.
Wow.
You make your own chair.
That's impressive. He is good.
He's very good. This guy working all the life in this shop. This is the poor truck he had. He is a poor guy in El Salvador. He had 3 cars, like a poor guy.
Okay, so we've met a lot of people that love Bukele. Yeah. We need to ask him why he doesn't like Bukele.
Rich people, right?
Yeah.
Well, rich people hate Bukele because you have to pay taxes.
Right.
He don't want to pay taxes. He want to be making money, but he don't want to give you money.
Right.
This is the office here. Look, his dad is over there and my sister's over there. Pick up piedra. This is one here.
You got that for him?
For him.
Because he started the shop,
She started the shop. Him and my sister. Look.
The original.
The original.
The original.
The original. Yeah. All the gang was there.
So this is an example of a wealthy businessman in El Salvador, or at least in Sonsonate.
The funny thing, nobody live here.
Wow.
Nobody live here.
Where does he live? I thought he lived here.
Somewhere else.
Yes, 3 women.
3 women.
Este lo compré poquito.
Yeah.
This is the way rich people talk.
This is the way people talk.
They say they don't have any money.
You don't have no money. When you live in the fucking the paradise. You know, he still think Bukele is bad. His reasons are because he's rich, you know, bro.
Okay.
When you rich, you know, what are you going to say about Bukele? Poor people care about Bukele, but not rich people.
So Fernando, through all his years here with his mechanic shop, he didn't have problems with the gangsters?
Oh, yeah.
He just paid them?
He paid.
And then
but
it's
remember,
no problem.
He's not a good guy too, right? He's not a simple guy. Santa Marta, this is the city here. Buddy, this is the dangerous fucking city. Like when the gang was here. In El Salvador, everybody paid to the gang members, but you be okay. You know, it's funny when people say, oh, Bukele doesn't win. You know what he say? Oh, don't worry about it. I pay to the gang members, I continue my life. This is the mentality Salvadoreño it is.
Who is he going to vote for then?
You see? When people talk, it's because people want to talk. But in the end, Bukele is the one, the number one in the power, right?
Right. We're at the apartment, we're ready to go. Everything closes at midnight because it's the election day tomorrow. There's no drinking allowed from the day before election day to the day after election day. Ban on alcohol countrywide, but we always have a plan.
Of course, in the summer, every day is our plan. Every day.
Thank you.
So since all the bars are closed, we have to have our own drinks, our own alcohol, and just explore the city. This is a park that is newly built by Bukele, and I want to show you guys this park. So this park is called Salvador del Mundo, which in English means the savior of the world. So it's dedicated to her, but it's also what the country was named after, El Salvador, the savior. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Even this is risky right now, even though we're Canadian, right?
Oh yeah,
fuck.
Of course.
So we're back in the historical center. I was here in my last vlog. If you saw it, then you already know. If you haven't seen it, click up here. But what you didn't see from the last vlog is they just built a brand new library that's open 24 hours. And supposedly it has a restaurant in it also. The interesting thing about this library is China built it. Building is massive, and there's all these old parliament buildings, and then you have this brand new library, and it looks like something from outer space. So as you guys saw, the first floor was like a kids play area. The second floor is older kids where you can play video games here, computer games. There's a whole Lego section, a relaxing section, plus books. We're only on the second floor. Also, like I said earlier, this place is open 24 hours, so it means it's staffed 24 hours, and there are staff everywhere. It's just amazing how much money goes into this, and there's families here with their kids. They're playing with Lego. There's some couples here just relaxing on the couch. Like, imagine a place right in the center of a city where you can just go to 24 hours a day, and there's multi-levels to do so many different things. That's not in my city. Maybe that's in your city, but this is incredible. All because of Bukele. So this is the top floor where people can play games.
You know, you come because you start follow the route.
There's a deck lookout as well. This place is incredible.
Okay, the restaurant is open. Okay, the restaurant is okay. The restaurant is open 7 a.m. to 10 p.m. Thank you.
depart from this beautiful country. By the time you're watching this, the election will already be over. But until then, let's pray that Bukele wins, and I hope you all enjoyed the vlog. Quick.